Hello viewers from a very lockdown, still completely lockdown Mumbai, and we are here awaiting Rathika Ramaswamy from joining in. She's just sent in a request. We shall be with her shortly. For joining in and being with us today is a very special session with Rathika Ramaswamy, one of India's foremost of wildlife photographers. Rathika, if you can hear me, can you please send in a request again?
Yes.
Hi, Rathika. Yeah.
Good evening, Madhavan. Good evening, all.
Good evening. Good to see you.
Yeah, same here.
So just a bit of a history. Rathika was the very, very first Instagram live that I did in my life. And now it's my great privilege to have you on the Better Photography channel, Instagram live channel. Thank you for accepting and thank you for being here, Rathika.
Thank you for the invitation.
There are a good number of viewers, in fact, and all of them, I think, are just waiting to hear from you and hear all the answers from you. Just to begin, a short description. I'm sure that everybody in the audience knows who you are, but just for a short description of Rathika, she's one of the foremost of wildlife photographers in India. Of course, that the fact that she is a lady wildlife photographer is a feather in her cap and a feather in India's cap, because she is one of the very, she's the only internationally known women wildlife photographers from our country. She has been doing this for a very long time now, and she specializes in bird photography. Apart from other, of course, she does all kinds of wildlife, but she also specializes, particularly, she's very well known for her bird photography. It has been her passion for the last 2 decades. Is that right, Rathika? 2 decades?
Yeah, more than 17 years, you can say.
17 years, since 2003, I think. That was the first time that we started. But you have done your management, you know, and this is a question that I ask. A lot of wildlife photographers seem to be in the zone where they study engineering, they study management, and then they get into wildlife photography.
Yes.
So my first question to you, Rathika, is how did you find a calling? I mean, what made you decide that you want to do wildlife photography? How did that happen?
Yes, Madhavan. Actually, I did computer engineering also. In those days, I am, I think, second or third set of computer engineering. Even my school, my place, I am the first engineering girl. There is a lot of many first comes. And after that, I did my MBA. The calling comes, photography, it was a hobby from the school days, Madhavan. When I was in 10th standard, I get a chance to visit in Agra. My father was an army officer. He was posted in Agra. So the 10th, we got 2 month holiday. So I had been there. The first thing, definitely going to visit Sitaj. Okay, so that I had been there, and all you can see the photographers, no? Tomorrow morning they will take photo, evening they will send it to you by post. So first time I seen photographer taking outdoor photography. Of course, before that we go to studio and family photos, no? Every year we took like this, a passport photo. So after seeing them and all, no, then I visited 2-3 times there. All the time photographs are taking photographs. Then we visited Delhi also. So I was telling my father, what if I have camera, then I can also take photographs. When I go back to school, I can boost off, no, that I had been these places. That is basically capturing my memories. Okay. So when I come back, my father gifted me a small camera. So it started from that time, Madhavan. And I got a home garden. I used to take flowers. I don't know, micro photography those days. But with that lens, I took flowers, trees, and even my parents also, like a candid photography. So after college, we used to go field trip and family travel and all. The camera is part of me. I always carry. Even at home also, I usually load with one film camera. So that any function, anything, always there will be some film in my camera. So it was started like that. Then after that, working time also, when traveling also, as a serious hobby. It was a serious hobby. Whenever I go, camera will be with me. And around 2001, the digital era came. I think Sony CyberSat, they introduced first. Though I was using film SLR, so I bought first 2001 Sony digital SLR. So with that camera, 2002, I was traveling for France, Paris and all. So the thing is, as soon as I after taking photograph, I can see the result. So before we used to wait to we come back and we have to develop, that excitement will be take some time. So here I am seeing all the initially instant result. No, for me it was like a magic box. So after I come back, I thought let me invest DSLR. So I was searching all the forum. Then D70, they announced Nikon. It was like selling like anything. Of course, I searched lot of forum also. But being a computer engineer, for me, I had a computer. 2000 itself, I got a home computer. Okay, at home. And the internet, MSNL in Delhi, the dial-up service comes. Slow it goes, and whatever you get internet. So through that internet surfing and all, I come across Deep Review. I was going through all the D70 review. Then I bought D70. So it started like that. The serious photography started this 2003 last later. Wildlife photography. Of course, I usually, before film camera, I used to take travel photography. That is, I love traveling also. That is one of my serious hobbies. I love traveling, people, culture. So after 2003, the wildlife photography happened. Everyone knows that I visited first time Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary. I fell in love with birds and nature. So from that one, there's no looking back, Madhava. Yeah, it started like this only.
Wonderful, wonderful. In fact, there was a question, I think, by Praveen, who asked, you know, was your schooling in Chennai or in Agra?
In my native, Venkataslam, Theni Venkataslapuram. Up to plus two, I was studying there. College, I came to Chennai. And after that, I shifted to New Delhi. Now, I moved back to Chennai.
I see. Okay. Now that you mentioned that 2002 was the first time, so you were one of the first few photographers who adopted digital cameras.
You can say Madhavan. But for me, it was those days. Who will imagine that going to digital SLR, you need to have
right.
computer also, you know?
Right.
Even for me
right.
also, the digital photography camera and all, know that I need computer to post process. Adopt I have no idea, but my basic engineering degree helps me easily to understood. I bought digital photography book and all. So although I know the technically I'm good, so it was easy for me to analog to digital and the post-processing and all. No, for me, those days it was available. Adobe freely it's available to download and Nikon Capture also. So my computer was as a workstation. For me, the changing from film to digital was easy. To understand the technically easy to understand and process also, to learn also. So you said, no, what, from computer to in engineering. And MBA also helps me to be in this field. You know, just taking photography is not enough to be sustained in this field. You have to know how to market, how to sell your work. So
that,
my
that
MBA helps
that.
Me.
So how does your MBA help you? You know, how does it actually help you now, you know, today?
See, those days, no one, I don't know anyone in the industry, Madhavan. I am new and no photographer friends also. Even my website also, I created my website. I know how to build and all. No, my website is still by me and I am looking after. And though 2003 itself, I bought space from Feebase. It's a frozen photography forum. Okay. And I used to publish my photographs, works and all. The first even assignments and all came through seeing that photographs only. And I am regular for the travel forum and all. Of course, see, the MBA first thing is, who is going to pay for you? It's your work or skill, you know? For that, you
right.
have to promote yourself. So I was
right.
a member of most of the travel forum and photography forum. I am a known person in those days. And I started with my photographer friends, Photography Art Association of India. There is one photographic interactive forum. So through that forum, many photographers knows me and I got many assignments, not only wildlife, Wildlife later on I specialized. I started only doing wildlife. And before that, I used to do editorial and people photography because I got all the equipment. So I had to utilize, you know, and travel photography. I did all other genre photography. So it helps me to promote myself, okay? And keep all the, what do you say, in my websites, photos, to participate all the forum and any photography events and all I used to attend. So it helps me. Though I don't know, that is, I am doing promoting myself, but I did without knowledge. Because of that, only people came to know that I am in this field. No one is there for me to promote. Even my family, no one knows photography. And slowly it started. 2000, through internet website only, 2008, I think, DD National contacted me. They were featured me. They said, you are the first human wildlife photographer. So after that, even 2006 lost itself, Better Photography interviewed me. Because of the Orkut. Orkut, I used to photos, I used to do all the photos and Facebook also. Through that portfolio only they came to me. So it's like this. There is a lot of process are there. I can take class also. I am taking class this next Sunday. How to promote, how to market your work. Being a photographer is not enough. You should know how to market yourself also.
That's actually quite admirable and wonderful. So all the viewers, please take note, Rathika Ramaswamy is conducting a workshop on how to market yourself. And that is something that if you really want to be a photographer, especially in India, within this field, within the field of wildlife photography, I think you should really, really attend this workshop.
And Rathika, it apply any genre, Madhavan, it apply any genre. Last week full, I'm doing one-to-one for the friend photographers. From their feedback that I thought I would like to share this knowledge to others also. Otherwise, it's not my idea to share my secrets and all, but I'm sharing it for upcoming young photographers. Already 50% registration over. If anyone is interested, please do join. No marketing, but it's enough. People are asking how to become successful. One line I can't answer, no, Madhavan. If they attend class, then I can. It's a, I think, 2-hour program. I can't reply 1 hour, one line.
So let me tell you, you know, what I personally admire about the way you've come up. You've done it in a very dignified and in a very, very nice way, you know. It was not over the top. It was not something that you overly marketed yourself. It happened in a very, very fluid and in a very nice way, you know. So I've been noticing how you, the kind of, some of the activities that you do and some of the things. I think I really admire the way in which you do it. So which is the reason why I'm saying that if any of the viewers would like to know how to really promote yourself, because promotion, self-promotion, I think would be the most important thing for a photographer. Yes. Please do attend this program by Rathika. Rathika, if I'm able to, I would also like to attend.
Please. You are free. You can join me freely, okay? And you get a lot of experience. You can take class, Madhavana, but you guys are busy, okay? That's why we are doing it. You guys are busy. You know all the thing in this industry. You know the pulse of the photography industry. If you announce the class ever, it will be full within 1 hour. I am sure.
No, but seriously, Rathika, self-promotion is something which is not easy. You know, it is not easy. And to do it in a dignified way is even more tougher. You know,
so even I started, people say, from actually 2002, I am online, Madhavan. From Trekker, all the photography forum, international forum and all, I am online always. But I maintain always my personal profile only. You won't find me any, these days only I am sharing personal pictures. I never share any personal things, anything. It's always personal photographs, anything. And of course, as you said, even I am an influencer, but it's only limited. Part of it, then I become an influencer. Otherwise, I don't want to bombard with my fans. So it's always, as you just noticed correctly, I just go, there should be some quality. Radhika Ramaswamy means there should be quality is also there, dignified way. I don't want to bombard my fans and unnecessary things. And all. They will find only good photograph. But I always available to them. Even I reply everyone whoever asks. Which camera lens are so boring, still I reply.
There is a question, since we are speaking about the workshop. How do we register for this workshop?
It's in my website, Madhavan. They can go there. And after payment, the link, registration link will be sent. It's only 2,000. I kept it very nominal. But my US photographers, I charge 100 USD. But for the Indian, now lockdown period, it's a 2,000 only. because I am contributing lot of, even I can give free also, but I am contributing lot of corona COVID-19 the cases for helping right. people, no? So for I need more funds to help them. That's why I am starting minimal thing.
That is also very admirable. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much, Ratika. So Ratika, so viewers, please note, Ratika is contributing to the coronavirus funds
yeah.
through the money that she is making through the
yes.
workshop. So please visit the website, ratikaramaswamy.com. Is that right?
Yes, yes, yes.
ratikaramaswamy.com. And you need to register there. The fee
yes.
is 2,000 rupees. And you can join the workshop in which Ratika is going to teach you how to promote
yes.
yourself and how to
yes.
market yourself, and it is important for you to know this. I personally am there are so many heroes working on the front lines of COVID-19
yes.
fighting this. We must support them.
So yes.
Ratika, thank you for that. Very admirable.
Thank you.
Moving into a different area of photography, you know, one of the questions that I had, of course, earlier we discussed that, you know, cameras are not important. It is not the equipment that actually makes the pictures,
okay.
you know, and you stress that, you know, you make it a point to actually mention it and stress that. So what is the most important aspects of bird photography, wildlife photography for you?
Yeah, for me, if you ask me, Madhavan, the 100%, only 30% is a technical knowledge. Okay, only 30%. Remaining 70%. As for any wildlife photographer, nature photographer, they should know the subject knowledge. So here, without subject knowledge, where you will go shoot? Okay, for example, tiger. So where to go tiger, and when is the best time to go, and which place you are going to shoot? So simply we can't randomly walk in. Okay, that is tiger is easy, but if you are going to bird photographer, become a bird photographer, you should know how the birds looks and where to find. When is the best season? So these are the things we have to know, that we usually say subject knowledge. Even after going in the field also, as a photographer, you must be able to track them, basic knowledge. You know, how the calls will be, how it looks, then only we can find them. Otherwise, the guide will be telling you the bird is there. But if you can't see, just your neck die. With all the knowledge only you will get. This, of course, one day you can't land. There are field guides are there. You have to go through the field guide where you are going to shoot and checklist. If it's a target species, where it's available, when is the best time to go, the local guide. So many things they have to know. And there are lot of, even one species also, Madhavan, there are lot of information. Their habitat, lifestyle, breeding habitat, so many things to learn. Simple bird species, you can take 1 week, I can land. So many things are there. So I request my upcoming, anyone who wants to be a wildlife or bird photographer, please read all the information, research your subject. And of course, these days, lens and camera, you can hire also. And don't obsess with the technicality. Nowadays, the cameras are all loaded with all the facilities. Don't spend so much time on the technicality, and instead of that, spend time on your subject. And the other things also, lighting, so many things, aesthetic part also you have to think. After going there, only focus point. These are the things they spend so much time. But when they came to my master class, I just tell them, after attending, they change the view. Before that, how to take short picture, they are loaded with the technicality. These are small things. Easily after one or two weeks they can improve. But the subject things you have to learn. These are my questions.
So you have a very big fan, you know, who is Manoj from Photo Division.
He keeps
sending me photographs.
Good morning daily. He sent me good morning daily.
Daily, yeah.
And
daily.
Birds also.
And he has shown a marvelous improvement, and he attributes a lot of that improvement to you, you know, by watching you shoot.
Yeah.
So
he attended my master class last year. He got
surprisingly
holiday from the department because of my workshop they gave. Otherwise, you know, he's 24/7 busy person.
yeah. A very sweet person, and
sweet, yes.
someone who's very dedicated, you know, so I
yes,
think he would make
dedicated.
A wonderful student too.
Yes.
So, tell us something about the master classes that he attended. Tell us something about the next master class that you might. Of course, COVID-19 is a problem, but tell us
yes.
something about what happens at a master class.
Yes, actually, COVID-19, I thought COVID-19, so I will wait for some time to announce Madhavan. But the thing is, for me, I am loaded with questions. When is the next master class? You won't believe me. One batch, I will take only 10 people. Now, already 5 people are registered. They are usually I conduct master class in Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary. Okay. It's a 3-day program. So complete, actually, pre-request will be basic DSLR they should know. Okay, we will usually send the questionnaires, how many years they are doing, which camera lenses and what the knowledge. So record after going through the questionnaire, the result, then it's not a first come, first and all. It's a selection process will be there. If anyone new person, then it's very tough because the other participant will be with all knowledge, with the new person, it's a tough to adjust. So if it's a new person, new to any photography, before the master class is itself online, we teach them. We teach basic everything, no? So we teach all the things. Then he comes to master class, he can join with other photographers. Usually 10 participants, and I do have my associate photographer. 5 is to one, the mentorship. And the first 2 days, we won't shoot anything. Okay, first 2 hours, it's a concept class, everything. Then we go there. I will be hand-holding with them. I will be standing with them, how to track, how to shoot, so many things. The instant result, I will see, I will give you the review also. So the third day, they have to go themselves. So they know after 3 days, they will be comfortable going alone and shoot. Okay, technically also, every day evening, there will be a review session. And even the field itself, we give review also. Okay, and every day we give next day assignment also. What are the photographs I want to shoot? And it's a very interactive, usually before RR, after RR, they say. Even the person who knows photography, as you know, bird photography is different, Madhavan. You know, bird photography, wildlife is different. The person who knows photography also comes the first day we review the photographs, we delete all the photographs. Okay, we delete all the photographs because the focus is out of focus. Even they know everything. It's a moving subject. Okay, here the subject, nothing is in our control. Lighting is not in our control. Subject, birds are not in our control. You have to sight, you have to track, and you have to compose aesthetically also. Everything, nanosecond, you have to do all the things. So even the person knows bird technically, the first day will be heavier, but second day they will get used to it. So it's a very interactive session. Anyone who loves wildlife bird photography, then they can attend. So it's a limited.
Okay, so,
and after this also, I do have private group in Facebook. Whoever attended my workshops, they become part of that group. It's not the learning, it won't be end that masterclass 3 days only. After that also, whenever they go shooting, they can post the photograph for the review. So it's a lifelong mentorship. I will be there.
That's wonderful. Radhika, you spoke about some of the challenges of bird photography. What are some of the other challenges that are there, especially for bird photography? I mean, what are some of the difficulties? I heard from Manoj that sometimes, you know, you actually are in the field, you walk with a heavy lens, you walk with heavy equipment, you walk for 6 hours sometimes in a day.
Yes. Now,
so what are some of the challenges in bird photography?
I won't say it's a challenge, Madhavan. Of course, any new person, it's a challenge, okay? But if you ask me, this is a part and parcel of a bird photographer. For wildlife photographer, if you are going to shoot tiger, then I can say not easy, but you will be sitting on the jeep, okay? You can keep all the equipment, the jeep will go, you sight and do photograph. No walking, no stressful. Only thing, you must be lucky enough to sight them. Here, bird photography, we have to walk. There is no park sensory, there won't be no vehicle at all. We have to carry the lens, sometimes 2 lenses, 1 lens with my backpack, 1 camera, 1 lens. And if it's a nearby place, I can take my assistant, my driver become an assistant. But like Sikkim, places like very far, sometimes you won't get anyone to carry your lens camera. Even they carry also, the bird will be sitting. Okay, before he set up, everything will go off. So the thing is, I have to carry myself so that as soon as I sight bird, I keep a tripod, I shoot. And a few forest birds, Manoj, they're very skittish, they're very fast. It was one of my toughest photographs in Sikkim. Though I sighted birds and they look very beautiful, they won't sit even 1 second also. So I cited 80 species. You can imagine only 40 I could take photograph. They are so fast. So that's a challenge. Of course, you have to walk very fast. You should be very fast enough to change your settings. The one bird will be sitting inside the bush. The next minute, same bird will be coming outside the open perch. So inside the bush, you will be increasing your ISO. Okay. So if it comes to open perch, I have to change my ISO, reduce ISO. So what usually I do, without taking my eyes from the viewfinder, I should be able to change my settings. So that's why the techniques of for wildlife photography, the technical knowledge should be your second nature, our second nature. Other right. donor, at least we have time to check. Okay, under exposure, we can change the settings. Overexposed, we can change the settings. But in wildlife bird photography, we don't have time to change the settings. It happens 1 second, there is no second chance. We can't ask
second chance. Right.
Yeah. But Masai Mara like places, you get a chance because lot of animals, and you will come across again and again them daily. So one day if you miss also, next day you can try. For bird photography challenges, few pieces, one day they have the timing. Early morning, evening, they will be busy, active. So if you miss, you won't get. So that is a lot of patience you need. Though we are seeing patience. Photograph, it looks as easy as, but it's not as easy as it looks. It's very tough.
I can imagine. Generally, in wildlife photography, I was mentioning to Kedar BD yesterday about, we had Steve Winter. And I actually met Steve Winter in Dubai. We were walking. And we were talking, we were going for a walk and we were talking together. And he mentioned that, how disappointed sometimes you get with, when you're shooting wildlife photography. Because, it's a lot of disappointment. And then suddenly you get that one shot, which makes you so happy, and grateful that you're a wildlife photographer. But that is, even wildlife photography, I'm saying that bird photography is so much more tougher than the average wildlife photography. Because, it is actually very difficult to, first you have to spot the bird, you have to know them, you have to compose, you have to create a visually exciting photo, so all of it is very, very difficult.
And I am doing my personal project videos also, birds, Indian birds video, Madhavan, these days. It's a personal project. You can imagine how tough it is.
I can.
Tough. Video is also very tough, but I am going to do Indian birds. One day you can see the film, but I'm still, it's going on, it's ongoing projects.
We will definitely wait for that film, and I will definitely personally be waiting to look at that film.
Okay.
So there is a question by Binit's Pictography. He says that we know the shooting at eye level is required, but at times it becomes very challenging. And it is a question that is very interesting for me also, because so the birds are sitting up there in the trees, and you do need to get to eye level, for the pictures to become interesting. So what do you do for that?
Yes, beneath there is some trick will be there to get eye level photography. See, the bird is sitting here, you will be standing here. Then the point of view will be look like this. But if you go a little bit far, then your camera to the bird, the lens distance, it looks like an eye level photography. But if you go very near, then it will be you are looking.
Then you're looking up.
Okay.
You're looking up.
Looking up. So this is the point of view. But of course, for water birds, you have to lie down. You do namaskaram, no? So that too, Bharatpur, we have lot of migratory water birds. So they have to lie down. And the good, very interesting thing about Madhavan, if you really want to lose weight, okay? If you go to northeast photography, the Sikkim and all, one bird will be on top. Okay, we will be going there. The next time, the other species will be in the bottom. So go there like this. Within 1 week, you can weigh 6-7 kg. I will assure you. My friend usually say, how you change? Now you come there, I will tell you how to reduce weight. This is the thing. We go like this. Within 1 week, you lose weight. Even eating well enough also, it's a lot of exercise. That's why usually, not only female, any female, even male photographer also, you should be mentally strong and physically fit. Otherwise, it's very tough.
Absolutely. So there
sometimes
you go.
Sometimes full day we will be walking. No sitting. Full day, morning to evening. Bharatpur and all, morning to evening, we will be walking and taking photographs like this.
So the best way to lose weight, you know, if you advertise that in a newspaper, you know,
yes.
you're going to get hundreds of people coming to you.
But weather will be East India. The weather was so pleasant, and the scenery is also very beautiful. So sometimes we never feel that you are walking. You will be enjoying also, but without our knowledge, we lose weight.
Wonderful. So, which would be your favorite places to shoot in India?
In India, I think everyone knows, but still I am telling. For birds, I love Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary, Madhavan. The reason is, people say, why, usually it's a cliche answer, but why I love is, the first place I visited Bharatpur Sanctuary, the place is where one park itself, you can find more than 300 plus pieces, with water birds, resident birds, raptors, and the lighting is very good. And for photography, you need good background also. So Bharatpur gives me good background. And winter also, it gives you foggy morning. So good background with good lighting, lot of vintage points. So if you notice, all my famous photographs are taken in Bharatpur only. The other place, I have to say, Jim Corbett. I love Jim Corbett also for birds and the places, for tigers, elephants. One place I go regularly. Every year, whether a suit is there or not, Jim Corbett, I go every month regularly. Bharatpur, so must I go. Two places are my favorite.
And how much time should someone spend? You know, let's say it's a person who's not used to bird photography very much. So how much time should someone spend, let's say, at a Bharatpur or a Corbett, especially Bharatpur, because Bharatpur is relatively inexpensive.
Yeah. Bharatpur, I think 3 to 4 days enough, Madhavan, to get good photograph. First day, you will be just exploring the park. So the second day, so every day is different. Every day in wildlife photography, that is the thing. Every day, the new species you will get. Okay, so you get a new chance to see some new. First day, you will be missing some species. In the second day, you will get. So minimum 3 to 4 days will be enough in Bharatpur. Of course, Corbett, they won't allow more than 3 days if you are going for a hobby photographer. They allow only, I think, 2 nights or 3 nights only inside the Corbett. But other places, you can stay outside. Other Tadoba and all, it depends on your budget. You can stay as many as day. You can book as many safaris.
Now, we are in a position of a lockdown, you know, so especially in certain regions in Mumbai, like Mumbai, for instance, a lockdown has been extended by 2 weeks. That is the case for most of the metro cities, I think. Lockdown has been extended by two weeks. Now, one of the kind of photography that, you know, is possible to actually do during a lockdown situation is bird photography, especially from your windows, especially from, you know, from your compounds.
Yes.
Now, for those people who are under lockdown, what advice would you like to give them?
If they're having macro lenses, Madhavan, they can do a lot of macro photography. But definitely, the bird photography is limited. Because I get only bulbul and parakeet, crow only. If you are lucky with near park and all, they get more birds. But I can suggest go for macro photography. Explore new genre also. Definitely, the lot of insects are there nearby park. Even the home garden itself, you can do. But after even traveling also, after it will take 2-3 months to become normal to go any safari. But in Mumbai itself, you have lot of wetlands. So if they are all limited traveling, you can go with wetlands and the flamingos are there. All the waders are, it's a breeding time. So all the waders will be breeding plumage. It's the best time to shoot also. All the resident birds will be, it's summer, they will be nesting also. All the parakeet, other larks, everything. So lot of things to do, even outside Mumbai also. There is no need to go outside, travel. They can do lot of things if they allow. Of course, after 2-3 weeks, the lockdown will be a little bit limited. No? Then you can travel to places.
Correct.
So
correct.
That they can do lot of things. Even Chennai also, any metro, Delhi photographers also, you can do explore nearby places itself. You can do lot of birding.
Now, you have been into bird photography and you have traveled extensively. You've seen what the degradation of the environment has been like over the last, since you've been doing it for so many years, you've seen the degradation of the environment. You've also seen that nature is rebounding back. especially in this last couple of weeks, the last few weeks of lockdown. Nature has changed. I mean, I can, of course, it's a matter of noise levels also going down, but I can clearly hear, you know, so many different species of birds just from my window. You know, so the I live in a fairly wooded area, you know, so I'm fortunate. But you suddenly become aware of the environment of nature because of the lockdown. So the lockdown has been productive in one way, of course. Economically, there have been issues, there have been other things. What are the lessons that we can learn from this lockdown? You know, what are some of the things that we can go ahead and do in the future, according to you?
Actually, the lockdown, you told, no, birds are there. Birds are already there, Madhavan. It's there already. But we couldn't hear the voice. And now it's very clear because less pollution and no car sounds, car and all. That's why everyone is telling we can hear the bird calls and all. It's coming. But now what will land? There is one, of course, economy is down, okay. Even as a photographer also, many people have learned this, their land. From home itself, we can do a lot of good photography. For example, if I am a tabletop photographer, I am a portrait photographer with limited lights, even window lights. So, if you experiment lot at the home itself, okay. Even tabletop photographer, a lot of people are doing good. They're experimenting different lighting and at home itself. If they have the 2-3 lights, then they can do a lot of good photography. But if they actually necessary to sit back and what we learned, even as a photographer also, you just go through your old photographs, okay, what, how far you came and what are the mistakes you did. Not mistakes, not others we can't see, but as a photographer, what we did wrong. So how to improve. So these are the things really it helps to, even for everyone, I usually travel also. For me also, I was always traveling. Home 2-3 days, 4 days only I back home. Now, I download most of the pictures. Now only I get a time to go through the pictures. So it was really go the introspect and what we did and what I can do. So sometimes even my perspective also a little bit changed. So what I can do. So as I told, you know, if I can't travel where to go, then now I have places to explore near Chennai. There is so many things we can do near our place itself. Okay, so many things I learned, hope other photographers also learned, and lot of post-processing, many upcoming photographers are running free webinars, everyone is giving free webinars and free talks, even for Bombay Natural Society also gave lot of birding webinar, free webinars. So it's a knowledge gathering also, knowledge sharing, knowledge gathering. Even I attended few different zoner also, like street photography, what they do, layering. So really, it refreshed for my mind. Hope for others also, it was useful. So instead of cribbing that we can't do, go out and all, this period we had to use.
Study and learn.
Study, learn, observe the knowledge and look around yourself. Other donor also you can check. It will really regenerate our mind. For me, actually, it's really refreshing. I'm really looking forward after this session. And as I told you, I thought no one will attend. And now itself, I'm getting inquiry. So the my bird photography and all master class is going, it's not standing. Usually I announce this time only. And this webinar also, Sunday webinar also, I thought, see, spending 2,000 is also big money. This lockdown
period. Correct.
So I thought who will come? So let me try. But already 50% it's a full. So few things to learn, we have to be spent. You know, both of have. So it's for me it's regenerating. I have learned so many things and I interacted like I never been live on any social media, though I have 1 million fans in Facebook or 10 years. I never been live on Facebook. I never felt that I want to go. But because of the lockdown, I thought, okay, let me go talk to my fans. And I just started Insta Live with Radhika. And like people like you come first time live. So it was really enrichful for me also, experience and listening their stories. And their experience, it gave me really good idea also. As a person, I learned so many things, Madhavan. I hope everyone also did.
Yeah, absolutely. At least speaking from the viewers' perspective, at our session, I know that they are having a good time because I am having a good time.
Yes.
They're talking to you.
And young photographer also. I learned so many inspiring things to learn from young photographer also.
Right.
So if it's other time, we don't have time to talk, we don't have time to work. Because of
exactly.
The
lockdown,
we get a chance to do.
Very true. So going slightly off track, because we have a couple of questions which I think you know would be interesting to answer. So we have a question by Venu 11 Photography. You know, so he says, "Hi, my question is, what's your opinion about hide and natural bird photography?
Yeah,
and Venu, don't you think that the hide photography with a feed will disturb the habitat?"
Yeah, Venu. It's actually most of the time, even I also felt hide is not ethical and all. But when we see the world, even Europe photographers and all, for birding, they have the backyard, okay? They do feed regularly so that they the birds won't miss. And usually they have photo hide and all. Even Vietnam and other China, other and all, you have hide, the self-hide. So without hide, you won't get that pieces. Even Satal also, like forest birds, they won't come outside at all. So the feeding is and all, they do regularly. And but stuff, if it's only you're doing for 1 week, then they'll leave it. That is not done, because what they will do after that. So most of, if you see, okay, take about Costa Rica, all the photographs, even for years, they have like our lodges, no? They have the bedding lodges. All the bedding lodges regularly feed the birds. Otherwise, the bird won't come out at all. It's a rainforest, they won't come out. They do 360 days feeding. So it's like a lodge, every day they feed birds. All the species always won't come out at all. So it's happening for all the years. So sometimes, where you will get like this. So it's not about ethical. This is normal these days, not only these days, for all the time. So, but instead of sometimes, see, for purpose of photography, if you are damaging the nest, then it is a call. Bird calls, even I don't encourage, bird calls is also not a thing, okay? So hide photography, without hide, you can't do any photography these days. Of course, bird sensitivities are fine, but if you want to go Costa Rica, Europe, or Vietnam, and all, it's a norm they are having hide. It depends on you. You don't want to hide, you want to enjoy nature, well and good. Even most of, I prefer nature photography only, because it's a hide is like a tabletop. You order, your birds are coming, okay? Once in a while, it's a fine. But to learn nature and birding, it's the best you go for bird sensitivities and the forest. Even I don't suggest, don't go as it is for hide photography, because once you used to hide, then you don't know how to track birds in the nature, wild. For me, for 14 years, I do only nature only. For last 2 years only, I am videographing. I use nowadays, I go once in a while for the hide photography, because for the videos I am going.
Very well said. I think you said it extremely well.
Yes.
If you are serious about bird photography, you will not use a hide. Because to the hide, it's almost like tabletop photography. It's like cheating in a way.
You are not putting any input, because birds are coming, you're just shooting. But if you know bird sensory, other places, you are going to look out for the birds. That happiness is different. If you sight, track, sight, taking photographs, it's different.
Right. There is one more question. It's a bit of a generic question, but it's a fairly common question, and so many people will have this question in their minds too. How to plan a photography trip, and what are some of the pre-tour arrangements that you personally do?
Okay, so actually the planning start 2-3 months before itself thing. For example, I'm going to Andaman. Last year I planned Andaman February. But I booked my guide May itself, because you need local guide. Okay, even though we know how to track birds, the local person knows much. So we book the guide first. If the guide is free, then I book a flight ticket, everything, my dates. Actually, it took only 6 months before itself. Okay, and first, after that, I want to see all the checklist of the Andaman birds. Andaman have endemic birds, more than 60 birds of endemic. Okay. So I usually get the checklist of the birds. Then we have book also. Indian subcontinent, we do have the books, Andaman birds also. So the bird and the book, this is the homework we usually say. I have to know, I should know how it looks, the bird. Okay, then only if I am going to the forest, then I can identify, oh, this is a copse owl, this is a Hume's owl. Okay, it's a target species, no? So we have to note down how it looks. These are the preparation, as I said, technically. But otherwise, lens also you have to carry. What are the lens you have to carry? You have to ask them first. The weather is very important. Even the dress you are packing is important. Okay, if you are going to beach photography, there will be beach and wetland. You will be lying down, so with half pant or cotton dress. And the weather will be humid, so we have to pack. If, for example, 1 week means not six t-shirts, not enough. You have to pack double, because morning itself you will be drenched with sweating, and afternoon you have to change. So these are the things also. That what dress you are going to pack, that also I take. I will take, and all the first aid medicines. Because there won't be no hospital nearby, basic medicines, I pack everything. Of course, camera lenses and batteries also, 2-3 batteries. Because if I go early morning, I will be come back evening only, few places. In the national park, we can't come back. It's very far from the portal. So all the few eatables also, like chocolate and dry fruits, because it gives you instant energy. Of course, you'll be having food. But as I told, you know, carrying lenses, lenda, no, after 2 hours, you get hungry, and water bottle, any energy drink also. So these are the things. It's a normal only. These are the preparation I do.
Right. There is, again, a very generic question, you know, which I think, again, is also something that comes very commonly. We are not going to answer the question saying which lens should I buy. You see, that kind of a question is something that you can read up a lot about. Yeah. But here is a question, which is the lens that you prefer most? Which is the lens that you use on a personal level?
See, few places, even Andaman also, and other places, Sikkim also, we had to trek inside the forest, okay? So that time, I carry 80 to 400 mm. Okay, 80 to 400 mm, because that is only, I can't risk my bag. But other times, I do carry both, 80 to 400 mm, and always 500 mm also. 500 mm is little less lightweight. Okay, that I carry. Sometimes I can handheld. But for my video and all, no, I need 800 mm. So I carry all the lenses. In the field, where I am going, depending on that, I carry. Most of the time, I use 70% my 800 mm with tripod. But few places going for the trek, but I have to take that pieces. Then there is no way to carry a tripod for one hour to hiking. So I carry 500 mm, always 80 to 400 mm. That I can have handheld also.
Right. Okay, thank you so much, Ratika. There is one comment that came through, which is like a self, you know, I feel good about this comment having come through. It's by Photography. It says, thank you, Better Photography, for the free May issue. So, yes, our May issue is completely free for download.
Thank you. Great, Madhavan. It's a really good. Last month also, you guys gave free issue, and I am yet to see. Let me see, and I will share the link also. It's a really, really nice, guys, guest, Madhavan, with all this lockdown period. You guys are doing your little bit of the things, okay? And keeping all the expense and freeing. Giving free issues, really great initiative. Thank you
so much. Yes, so the issue is free. You can download, all the viewers, you can download the issue from by just going to betterphotography.in. Just put in your email ID and the download will automatically start. My suggestion though is, when you're viewing this free copy of the issue, download it into a folder and then open it separately using Acrobat Reader is completely free. It's a free reader from Adobe, directly downloadable from the Adobe website. When you view it through Acrobat Reader, you'll find the spreads of the magazine joined in the correct way, because usually what happens is, on the cell phone or on a browser, it is page by page. You know, so some of the double spread photos are not joined. But using an Acrobat Reader, you can see the double spread photos the way it's supposed to be seen. Going forward, we might go back to the print edition again, but during the time of the COVID lockdown, we decided to keep the April and May issue completely free. You can still download both. Either the April or the May issue is free for download on the Better Photography website. And Ratika, thank you so much. There's one more small little thing that I want to give. If Srikanth is watching this program, Srikanth is someone who attended our workshop, you know, and he gifted me this mug. Yeah, he gifted me this mug with this photo on it. You know, Srikanth, I'm using your mug. Thank you very much, Srikanth. And if anybody from the paint workshop, is around, just tell Srikanth that, you know, I put this mug on a live session with Ratika. You know,
that's
so
great. Good.
Yeah. So I'm having my chai from your mug, Srikanth. Thank you so much.
Okay.
And Ratika, thank you. Thank you so much for being with me this evening. It has been a real pleasure. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you, Madhavan, for the invitation. And thank you guys for joining us today. And it was pleasure really talking to Madhavan, because I am doing last of Insta with others for asking questions. This is the second time, because I don't want to go live with anyone, because I have seen it many times. But I know Madhavan will be asking different questions. I said, okay. But really, I enjoyed the session, Madhavan. Thank you, guys. Thank you, everyone, for joining us today. Okay, hope you enjoyed the session. Any questions, do watch. I think Better Photography is coming up with really good sessions coming days also. Please do follow and please do watch. Thank you, Madhavan, once again. It was a pleasure.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Ratika. Bye. See you all. Bye.
Okay, bye.